Hey guys, how you doing? Tenery Mowers and Blowers. It's a nice, cool summer day on a Saturday. It's about 80 degrees. It's been 95 and 100% humidity the past 5 days. We need the rain for sure, but today's a nice, gorgeous day. Not too hot, not muggy at all. Anyway, so I'm working on my new garden tractor today. 20 horsepower, 46 inch wide. It's got a blown engine, according to the previous owner. I got this thing for 40 bucks. Whole thing is sound. Nice wheels. It actually cranks. When you turn it, it cranks. But it bumps a few times. You know what I'm saying? So I'm thinking it through rod. Maybe one, maybe both. We're going to test that today. I'm definitely going to have to take apart the engine, no doubt about it, but I'd like to find out if it's both rods or just one rod, right? So we're going to do that by taking out the spark plug. I'm going to stick a screwdriver in there, try to rotate the flywheel by hand, and see if it pushes out, to see if one or both pistons are still connected to the connecting rod. I've worked on these Murrays before. Not a garden tractor, but I did work on a lawn tractor before. I sold that for about 500 bucks. It was a nice tractor. Had the same engine in it. Engine's fantastic. These opposed twins that Briggs & Stratton made. Very smooth, you know. I also like the new Briggs V-Twin Intech as well. Very smooth engine. So, really love the engine, which is why I'm going to try to salvage it. If there's not a lot of piston scoring in a cylinder, I'm going to just, you know, get new rods and put it in, you know. Hopefully it's an easy fix, but if not, I'll track down another engine, because the tractor itself is sound, you know. There's no rust anywhere. Tires are like new. Love the big ones in the back. For you enthusiasts, this is the model number, and the tranny, I believe, is a Tough Torque hydrostatic. It's a K65. Has a good battery, which you never find in used tractors. Keeps its charge and cranks. I haven't charged it yet. First thing I'm going to do in terms of steps, I'm going to remove the hood, because removing the hood is going to make it easier for me to work around the engine, and it appears to be just these two bolts take this bracket off, which is seems like permanently mounted on the to the hood. So it should be just these two bolts. And these two bolts take the hood off, disconnect the light. Then I'll have access to check the spark plug, which I'll take out, and we'll see what happens. Then after that, before I remove the engine, I'm going to drain the oil so I don't make a mess, you know. We're not going to use that oil anyway, so got to drain it. That's what I'm going to do. Remove the hood now. This side removed. Light disconnected. I knew that was going to happen. It just fell. I just removed the spark plug. And actually, it looks good, you know. It's not a lot of oil buildup, which you would normally find, I think, if you had a blown engine. Some carbon buildup, you know. So, I'll take the other one off. So, I think both connecting rods are busted, because pistons are not moving at all. Got the screwdriver stuck into this hole, rotated this several times, didn't even move. Did the same thing on this side, didn't even move. So, probably both pistons are not connected to the crankshaft at all, so, I guess it's a teardown. got to tear it down anyway, right? So I'm going to remove most of this static over here and then undo the bolts underneath of the engine bolts and then try to lift it. While removing the linkage, got to make sure that I take pictures so I know exactly where they went. Around here, middle hole. This one, first hole. So this guy had this contraption going on with the throttle, so for now, I'm gonna have to take a picture of that too, because I don't know what it does yet. I've unrouted the fuel line, disconnected it from the fuel pump, okay, out of these two brackets there. The wiring, going to disconnect this ground wire, right? And then these two lead to that. Fuel, have to clamp that off. So, it appears that the engine is now pretty much disconnected in terms of hoses and wires all the way around, and throttle linkages have been disconnected. So I think all we need to do now is disconnect the battery power to the starter. And then that's when I'll crawl underneath and loosen the four engine bolts, right? Before I do that, I'm going to drain the oil. And to drain the oil, that is the oil change oil reservoir right there. See how much oil is left in here. This is for you, M. Gomez. This will definitely have an oil change. Of course, as always, the entire reservoir came out because this part here is stuck. It just makes more of a mess. Same thing though. Just get the oil out. Yucky. Really bad oil. Nobody said changing the oil was going to be a clean job. You know? When I remove this engine, if I remove it, no, I'm going to remove it. If I remove the engine, I'm going to power wash all this stuff. Gives me a good opportunity, you know? I think this thing will clean up really well because there's not much rust. I see some here and there. But really, a sound tractor with decent paint still, you know? While I'm waiting for most of that oil to drip out, I'm going to remove the top engine cover so I can have a better grippage of the flywheel to turn it and stuff. What would I do without my impact driver? So far, guys, this Black & Decker one that I got for only 60 bucks, it works great. Thought I'd plug that in because I wanted to get a DeWalt, you know, but that was like almost triple the price. Gotta get the two bolts that are holding on the dipstick too. Okay, so I just removed the two bolts from the dipstick. Clean this, you dipstick! You guys old enough for that? Well, I'm showing my age. Okay, I'm taking bets. Rat's nest or no rat's nest? Come on, 5-1 odds. Wow, look at how clean that engine is. I am absolutely amazed. Look at that. That is absolutely the cleanest engine I've ever seen. That's insane. I thought for sure there was going to be a rat's nest in there, or at least crap, you know? That is clean, man. Almost a damn shame to rip it apart, you know? Okay. I'm going to put the oil plug back. M. Gomez, I hope you enjoyed it. This one was for you. It doesn't have to be tight, but I will tighten it because I want to make sure I tighten it before I finish all this stuff. Now, I hope you boys are being responsible now. You're not dumping all that oil into our reservoirs and the lakes and the sewers and all. Because you know that stuff ends up winding up to be into our drinking water, you know? I'm far from being a super conservative or anything like that, but just dumping old oil into water like that is just not cool, you know? Gotta make sure you dispose of it, at least put it into a container or something like that, you know? Now I'm gonna remove that starter power lead. Disconnected the lead, and while I was at it, disconnected the negative battery on the negative terminal on the battery, and so we don't have any crazy accidents and nobody electrocutes themselves and puts themselves into fibrillation and dies. So from draining the oil, I made quite a mess, and now I have to crawl under there and get those bolts out of the way. So I'm going to have to clean that part up a little before I have my hair full of Earl. It's been an absolute ordeal. Spent about an hour trying to get those bolts out. The engine bolts actually were not the originals. I think two of them were originals. One of them were double-sided. You had a bolt on top there just to hold it together. And now I'm just checking to make sure that I gotta remove the pulley, crankshaft pulley first, because I don't think this will fit through there, through that hole. This one will. But I gotta remove this one, which it's a pain. I can't even feel what size that is. But anyway, it's been an ordeal for sure. I'm not having a good time, put it that way. So I couldn't fit my impact wrench underneath the pulley. Wouldn't fit, you know, so I had to jack up the machine, put it on jacks. I will say it's a little disconcerting being down here, but I know there's enough clearance for me because I was just lying here before, and even if it did drop, I don't think it'll be crushing me. It'll maybe hit me on the head or something, but anyway, hopefully now I'll have enough clearance between here and there. I did find out what size bolt that is, and got it on my impact wrench now. See if we can get this damn pulley off. Success, success. I tell you, success. Yeah, all right. There's a connection. Turn this. Oh, damn it, hit me right in the nose. Alright. That took pretty much all morning, man. It sucked. Anyway, so, pretty sure that engine is loose now. And, I made this little contraption here. Where it's a, kind of a wood crate on wheels, you know. Should rest there okay, I hope. And that way I can make the engine mobile. So I'm going to try and lift this up by myself. I mean, it's not that heavy. You know, I mean, sure it is, but I think I could lift it. You know, I'm stronger than I thought. It lifted out okay. It wasn't too bad, man. So as I put it on here, I realized that it was a little bit too wide, and that the muffler pipe was getting in the way of me storing it correctly, as well as that Cletus, you dipstick! That oil-changing reservoir. So I had to throw two pieces of wood that was luckily nearby my feet. So I had one hand on one holding it with some tension and slipped one through, held the other side, slipped the other one through. And so there we go. Nice and stable. And the engine is now mobile. So I can like sit here and open up this thing and check out the situation. In the meantime, this thing's just sitting here on ramps. I'm gonna clear out all my tools, get rid of all this static around it, and I guess I could power wash it tomorrow or something like that. But And that was an ordeal, guys, to get that engine out of there. But you know what? This was the first time. Well, no, that's not true. I did remove an engine to change a sump gasket once. But it's the first time I'm getting into the innards, you know, of an engine. But yeah, it's a good experience, no question. Was it fun? Eh, kind of. Does it take a lot of time? Sure it does. But man, I'm pretty proud of myself, man. Moving an engine. Now, of course, can I get the engine back in there? It really wasn't all that difficult, guys. Anyway, so my next step, I'm going to go eat something, drink something. I'm going to take that panel off just so I can check out exactly what's up. So I just spent some time power washing this thing. Now that the engine's off, I had an opportunity to get to the spots that I would normally not get to, you know. Cleaned up the gas tank. Everything looks pretty nice. Before I got to this area here, the hose to the power washer was touching the muffler, and it sprung a leak. So it melted the hose. It's all trashed. I can't continue. I can't finish. It drives me crazy. So I have to get a new hose. In the meantime, I just gotta leave this here. I'm pretty sure nobody will steal it. It's on ramps. Got the rest of the stuff in the back of the truck here. All power washed, nice and clean. And I rolled the engine into here after I power washed that too. You know, just did it once over, good enough. I made sure the panel was facing me so that I'd be able to take it off tomorrow. It's getting late now. I worked all day on this thing. Just getting the engine out of there. Unbelievable, you know? But you know what? It's a learning experience for me. Like I said, I only took an engine off of a tractor once to change the sump, you know? It wasn't too bad, I don't recall. This one's a lot more significant, you know? I gotta get my hose, or a new hose, so I can at least power wash the deck. This deck is nice, huh? Really good shape. Unlike the Husqvarna, where, yeah, that looks okay, but then, guess what? This one's all messed up here, see? I'm gonna try to fix that somehow. Guy actually came to look at this today. I had it for $8.75, and then he saw that, and he didn't want it. Not for $8.75, you know? Nobody would want it for $8.75. Anyway, so that's a project I'm gonna get to. Anyway, so this was part two of my Murray Garden Tractor project. It's going to be a lot of parts to this one, too. Stay tuned. Thanks for following me, guys, and watching my progress. See you guys next time on Mowers and Blowers. Well, I figured I might as well just take off these bolts at least, and at least I can see what I'm looking at here, and maybe tonight I could order parts, you know. Well, I guess I can't expect it to just pop off, right? Just cracked it. I don't mean crack it, but you know what I mean. That's not good. Look at all the loose parts in here. Not good at all, guys. Because of all the little bitty parts that are in there, moving it around and stuff, things probably got damaged, you know? And, well, I guess if the piston wasn't moving, maybe the cylinders are okay. Let me know what you guys think. Is it worth salvaging? Or do I have to do more and take some more stuff out? I mean, I assume I still have to get in there to clean out the parts, right? Because you can't have anything left in there, right? So which means I have to take the sump off
Leave in the comments, guys.
Let me know what you think. Remember, this is the first time I'm doing this. So I could use some help. Alright? Anyway, looking forward to your comments, and see you guys next time on Mowers and Blowers.
I figure I rotated and attempt to take the heads off, just so I can get a better look. I don't know what I would do with an impact driver, guys. I know all you guys have this, right?
It's a lifesaver, seriously. It popped off very easily. I think that gasket actually is still good to go. Just gotta be careful, you know?
Doesn't look too bad, guys.
Very minimal carbon buildup. I'm gonna try to push it out, take it out. So I just gave that a little push and it popped out. Gasket looks good. I mean, okay, you know? It looks usable. We'll save that. And here is the piston. There it is.
Rings look good.
Even by feeling it, still has that sharp feeling, you know? Very sharp. And in here, the cylinder wall, smooth, guys. There's no scoring whatsoever. Be it. You know, you can't even feel it. You see, you may be able to see a little bit of a line, but it's smooth as silk. All right, well, this wall's good. This piston and this wall is good. I'm gonna get the pieces out of there without scratching it.
I'm hoping it's just two connecting rods that I have to order and some gaskets. That would be awesome. I'm gonna shine a light so you guys can see.
When I feel with my hand, smooth. Can't feel any kind of nicks or scoring. I mean, maybe very slight, but it's very smooth. Another question for you guys. So this is the, okay, so that's the back of the engine facing forward, right? So this is the right side piston. Now when I put it back in later, you know, how do I, is it this way? Or is it that way, you know? Because you see there's this little notch there on the right side of the hole. And on the other side, there's a notch on the left side of the hole. How do I know which one to put in, you know? Which side, this one or that one, you know? And how do I get the rings to compress to get it back in? Just push it in with my hands, you know? Like I said, I've never done it before. But anyway, I'm gonna have to label this part here, the right side of the engine. I'm gonna flip it around and take apart the left side.
Same thing, came off really easily. And this gasket looks good too. Walls are also very smooth.
This is great. Looking very promising, guys. Looks like I could just get a couple of connecting rods. And I don't know what this panel is called, but gasket for that, for sure. I think these might be okay. But I'll price them out anyway. Still, I got to check the insides, right? I still probably have to take the sump off because a lot of debris down there. Definitely have to clean that out, right? That sucks. Same goes with this side. Smooth. Really smooth. No scoring. I don't know. You guys tell me. Is all I need there are two connecting rods and gaskets? Because it's smooth. Doesn't look like the cylinder wall is scored whatsoever. So I think it's good.
You guys let me know.
So after further review, it appears that I definitely will need a new piston. At least a new piston. And two connecting rods, one piston. Now, do I buy the left piston, or are they all the same? You know what I mean? Now, when I took this out, I noticed that that notch was pointing forward, okay, on the top. This part was pointing backwards. So I'm assuming the notch means forward. So I should put the piston in this way, forward. That's where the carburetor is, right? Please, guys, tell me. Leave your advice in the comments area, all right? Before I order this thing. Tell me whether or not I should order this thing or I can't order this thing. And you guys are telling me to throw this engine away. But I'm telling you, I'm feeling this. If I was blind and I did this, I would say that's a good engine. Okay? That's the way I'm putting it. No scoring at all, okay? Now, look at this crankshaft there. Is that cool? Is this rub here cool or no? Or do I need a new crankshaft? Because then if I need a new crankshaft and a piston and connecting rods, then I'm not going to fix it.
Because if it's going to cost too much money, you know me, I'm not going to do it. I'll just buy another engine. And then I'll part this out. But you tell me if that's good to go or no. Because if I put my finger on it, it feels kind of sharp. You know what I mean? I could cut my finger, sort of, if I put enough force.
Okay, guys, so I don't think I'm going to rebuild this. As you guys can see, it's a camshaft. It's busted in half. Maybe three places. So right now I tried to get it loose, but it's just stuck. You know, it won't come out. Stuck. So that's the camshaft. It's stuck in there. I mean, what do you think? Is this too much for me to fix? It is, right? Camshaft. If that part over there is no good, crankshaft. Piston. Connecting rods.
Is it too far gone?
It's a shame because the walls are good, you know?
Alright, I'm gonna wait and see what you guys tell me to do. See you guys next time on Mowers and Blowers. So since I decided that I probably wasn't gonna rebuild this engine, I brought my carcass back into the garage.
It's not gonna sit out there all day until I decide what to do, right? So I flipped it on its face, on its head, and that's the sump. I just removed all the bolts. Take this off. Oh, the carnage. The carnage. There's a sump. This looks really unusual right there. Is that normal, guys? This? That doesn't seem normal to me. That can't be right, right?
Is that supposed to be there? A clamp? That's retarded. Let me know what you guys think, man. Let me know what I should do. Okay, now, I'm done. See you guys next time on Mowers and Blowers.